So the head pivots off of these, so you, off of this bolt here, and this adjusts your pitch for the head. So we'll remove those two, and what you'll find is there is a connecting piece that fits onto the back, and then the two bolts go through. So you have your bolt that provides the pivot point, and then you have the adjustment bolt. And just like on the other part of the head, when we pull these and put them together, we want to make sure that we have the smooth side of the washer towards the metal on the unit itself. Once we've pulled the unit apart, so our pivot point here, remove this part of the head, and then apply lubrication to the area where it will move, both the unit, the arm itself, and then the back of the connection point on the head. You'll notice that I will put a little bit of grease inside the sliding part of the moving parts as well. The threads on my pivot bolt, and then make sure that the rounded edge of the washer is going to be towards the machine. I'll make sure there's lubrication on the washer and on the threads of my locking bolt. So on the back, we have this piece which goes along the back of the head. Pivot bolt goes into the alignment hole, and then that will actually fit onto the threaded double bolt or double nut that goes along the back. Lock that into place, and then our sliding lock bolt into the second threaded portion of the nut. We'll tighten these up and we'll go to the next step. Along the back of the arm, we have this pivot point. So this pivot point, we'll make sure that we lubricate where this will slide and on the other side as well. So make sure that you also apply lubrication where that fits inside the track as well. So when we're ready to place the head back into position, this part will be lubricated, center it, drop it into its place, and at this point we'll actually attach the springs and reattach the head to the press. So all right, I have a small oil lubricant applicator, and we're going to, while we have access to the head underneath, we're going to actually place oil inside these rollers. Give them a little spin. It's at this point, obviously, we would clean those and make sure we have this maintained and ready to go. This area obviously is important in that all of the head pieces actually lock into these rollers, and they need to be able to be move freely and be clean so that they can slide into the locking pieces and stay in position. To prevent the unit from actually making a little bit of noise, squeak, and the scrape, if you actually apply a little bit of lubrication where the locking mechanism actually slides back and forth, you'll notice that will move a little easier. So once we are now assembled and we come up into position, we can see exactly where the pivot points are. As you can see, that actually lubricated this movement up and down, making this much more smoother for the user. And then also, before we bring down, I would suggest highly that you actually lubricate the threads that go up and down, and that allows you to move this piece.
I'm Doug Grigger. Thanks for watching.
please be sure and smash the like button if you enjoyed and or found this useful. Make sure that you share with your friends if they need this, and also make sure that you comment or ask questions below. We'd ask that you go to the website links below, sign up for the newsletter, find useful information and many blog articles there that you might actually find just as useful as this video.